Mr. President, the very essence of this important bill is the extension of the change culture of government into rural area so as to make our rural dwellers have a feel of good governance. Mr. President, dear colleagues, the major significant index of measuring the level of social economic growth and success of any nation lies in the level of growth at their rural areas, and the agency which this bill seeks to establish, Mr. President, will help our nation meet the challenges of the Sustainable Development Goals and Sustainable Human Development Rights among rural communities in line with the National Economic Empowerment and Development Strategy. The need objectives of this bill is to give our rural areas a boost in terms of infrastructural development as well as improvements of their living standards. These will be achieved through the establishment of the agency with specific function of fostering community environmental and ecological sustainability. Over two-thirds of Nigerian population resides in rural areas. Increasingly, poverty in the country is wearing a face that looks like rural face. From 28.3% in 1980, poverty among rural population grew to 51.4% in 1985. It has since risen to 69.8% in 1996. Poverty tends to affect men and women differently. Women are generally less educated, more vulnerable, deprived, and powerless than their male counterparts. Poor people experience insecurity, vulnerability, drought, desertification, flooding, deforestation, etc. This is because of lack of empowerment to influence public policy according to their priorities and lack of opportunity for income generation and benefits from markets. Access to education, safe water supply, sanitation, health, modern energy, telecommunications, and roads are important in reducing vulnerability and increasing prosperity. Critical infrastructure services like water, energy, and telecoms come at a relatively high cost for rural dwellers, while scale, density, distance, and purchasing power of rural communities tend to increase investment costs. Inappropriate government policies can also drive the prices for these commodities in rural areas. Essentially, expenditures on water and energy often represent a large proportion of the disposable income of rural households. While some of these costs are monetized, others are informal and come in form of time, drug spent by mostly women and children in collecting water and gathering woods. In a survey conducted by UNICEF in Nigeria, water supply and energy services top the list of the most pressing needs of rural households. In the survey, 77% of households rated access to adequate and safe water as the most crucial, critical element in escaping poverty. Access to electricity came second at 53%. The agency which this bill seeks to establish will evolve and implement policies and programs in areas of self-sufficiency in food, enhancement of community productive activities, income generation, employment opportunity, reduction of community urban migration, poverty eradication, and ultimately mainstreaming the community dwellers into national development as well. Collaborate with federal government ministries and agencies, international development partners, state governments, local governments, and private and public sector organizations, institutions, and enterprises, plus individuals for the purpose of enhancing, coordinating resources for implementation of community development programs and projects. Mobilize and empower community population to create wealth through increased agricultural, industrial, and other productive activities. Promote the expansion of the productive base of the community economy through creation and expansion of non-agricultural enterprises. Provide community support, services needed to bring about increased production of goods and services, and provide access to extension services, inputs, credits, marketing services, and to raise community productivity in general. Establish an integrated network of cottage and small-scale industries and promote the acquisition of vocational and trade skill, arts and crafts. Improve the human resources and technological capacity of community through education, training, extension and technical support services that facilitates the adoption of relevant technology by community producers. Develop community areas and raise the quality of life in community through the provision of community feed roads, potable water, sanitation, regular power supply, good health facilities, and other socioeconomic facilities. Great network of community marketing and distribution infrastructure to enhance profitable exchange of products between markets. Encourage activities aimed at conserving community environments with a view to enhancing the preservation of life form and conservation of natural resources as key to sustainable development. Serve as vehicle by government to promote its policies and programs for implementation of integrated community development. Harmonize activities of various poverty alleviation institutions in the country with a view to ensuring a more cost-effective and coordinated implementation of integrated community development and poverty alleviation programs. Mr. President, dear colleagues, there is need for a coordination of major policies for the development of our communities. This is what this bill seeks to address. The promotion of this bill is my humble contribution to correct these problems that have been hindering the overall development of our rural communities in Nigeria.